Upon his murder on the 7th of January, the wife of the late Masindi District Health Officer, Dr. Abiriga, claimed the deceased had received a mysterious call that night but never returned. However, during investigations, police discovered that Cherotich Betty, a widow, now a prime suspect, had first planned to kill her co-wife in December last year. But when the plan failed, she decided to eliminate the husband.
It was established that the plot to murder the deceased began after Cherotich Betty learned about a second relationship that her husband had with a lady called Atuhura Susan in Masindi. And of course, as a result, she first hatched a plot to kill her concubine or co-wife. And the first attempt was by setting fire on her house, which was put off by neighbors. That matter remained under investigation.
Upon failure to kill her co-wife, Cherotich decided to kill the husband. Police further revealed that two contract killers had been hired by Cherotich Betty to murder the husband. She paid 2.5 million shillings to have the job done.
So it was a result of those two failed murder plots against her co-wife that she shifted and plotted to murder her husband, whom he had chosen first of all for the death of their firstborn, the miscarriage of their twins, and she also was angered that the husband, that is the late doctor, would always insult her for being a bad performer sexually.
Cherotich Betty is charged along Joshua Mamreng and Martin Chipsang, both residents of Buku District. The trio allegedly hacked Dr. Abiriga to death before transferring his body a few meters away from his home.
She led them into the bedroom. They had two, the hand hoe sticks. They had two of them, so they found when the victim was asleep, and they hit him on the head with the hand hoe stick, dragged the body to the floor, and then they slit the throat of the late doctor.
From the Kampala Metropolitan, police are continuing with operations to crack down on the theft of road furniture and signposts, especially from the Northern Bypass. Dozens of suspects were arrested and are yet to be arraigned in courts of law.
We continue to investigate and carry out operations on incidents of damaging and vandalism of road furniture, security lights, and signals. This is after we registered incidents of vandalism on Northern Bypass, where metals that are used as barriers on bridges, culverts, are being taken apart.
Meanwhile, the Uganda Prison Services have expressed concern over the overwhelmingly increasing number of inmates, which is putting pressure on the limited resources.
Our numbers are increasingly becoming bad, because by this morning, convicts we have 39,602, remands we have 37,555, debtors are 435. A total of 77,592. And I think you remember in December we are in the lower 76,000. So it means during Christmas some people decided to do funny things.
Despite the influx of inmates, the number of prison warders remains constant, a thing which overstretches the already limited resources.
We continue to have 14,297. A few things that we realized last year include the congestion levels remained at the, okay, they increased because they were, the previous year they were at the 34, now they became 362.6%.
Several prisons across the country are currently grappling with congestion, with the water to prisoner ratio standing at 1-7, and this has been blamed on a number of factors, including the low conviction rates. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.